Commissioner Leonardo Guerrero, represented by Jesse Cordona, okay, and Treasurer of the Philippines, Rosalia De Leon, represented by Ms. Reina D. Suarez, okay? So, at this juncture, I would like to include in the public hearing the subject matter of the Senate Joint Resolution Number 12, a joint resolution authorizing the use of the excess collection of the Bureau of the Customs for the year 2020. And the latest report from the Bureau of Customs, meron silang 2019 pang natitira. So together, we want that money to be used as cash assistance for the rice farmers to be included in the General Appropriations Act. To recall, under RA 10203 or the Rice Tarrification Law, there is a provision for an earmarking of 10 billion yearly for the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund aimed at modernizing the rice sector. The law provided also that if the annual tariff revenues from rice importation exceed 10 billion pesos in any given year within the six-year period following the effectivity of the act, the excess tariff revenue shall be earmarked by Congress and included in the GAA of the following year. Then they will choose if they will give it to the rice farmer, financial assistance, the titling of agricultural rice lands, expanded crop insurance program on rice, and crop diversification. According to the Bureau of Customs, the collection in revenues amounted to January to September of 2020. This is preliminary. It's 13,681,767,109.19. Okay. And I saw in the budget of agriculture, they're putting the another amount of more than 1 billion for crop diversification, which I think we should put na lang in the financial assistance to rice farmers together with this tentative 3.6 billion. So, kasi tingin ko, mas gusto naman natin na ibigay na lang sa rice farmer kesa gawin pa sa programa. Marami naman programa ang Department of Agriculture. Kasi yung 3 billion, pag dinivide mo, kasi yung rice farmers owning 1 hectare and below is 600,000, diba? Pag dinivide mo doon ng 3 billion, sa 3 billion sa 600,000, 5,000 pesos lang ang isa noon. Oo. So whatever money we can raise in excess of rice tarification, we just give as financial assistance to the rice farmers. Kasi ang dami-daming complain na bumaba daw ang price ng rice because of this, because of that. So maybe to soften this complaint, we'll just give them financial assistance, lalo na ngayon pandemic, di ba? May I hear from Senator Amy Marcos?
Yes, we fully support the joint resolution that the excess collections be carried over into the regular budget for 2021. And also the wise suggestion that it should be allotted for crop diversification, thereby allowing more fiscal space in the HGAA budget, with only the quibble that the undervaluation allegedly going on in customs, as well as the failure to collect the 1.4 billion charged against 40 erring rice importers, be investigated and prosecuted thoroughly. Thank you, Paul.
So, kasi i-decide natin how much we will give and then to whom we will give. So, yes, Secretary Kiko. Ay, Senator Kiko.
Yes, thank you, ma'am, Madam Chairperson. We support the proposal that immediately cash assistance be the priority disbursement for the excess. Because precisely, tama po yung nabanggit ng ating Chairperson, una, pandemya. Malaki talaga ang epekto nito sa ating mga magsasaka. At pangalawa rin, because this is the there is excess palay during the second half of the year, 60% of our palay production is in the last quarter and therefore talagang bagsak ang presyo at makikinabang mo talaga ang ating mga rice farmers dito sa ayuda ng cash assistance.
Secretary Binay, rather Senator Binay is raising her hand. Okay lang? You support?
Yes, Madam Chair, I support the position of the Chair. Siguro, Madam Chair, for the record lang ho, kay Secretary Dar, magkano na ho ba talagang bilihan ng palay ngayon?
We recognize Secretary Dar. Secretary Dar, you're mute.
Opo. Unmute. Nasaan dito? Okay na?
Yes,
okay na
yes,
po?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, to the chairman and the members of the committee, we would like to mention that for dry and clean palay, 14% moisture content, yung farm gate price po natin ay 19 pesos. Pero ang problema ngayon po ay may tagulan, so kulang naman tayo ng mga post-harvest facilities. Ang wet ay kung maganda yung di pinakamaganda na presyo 14 to 15 yung wet, but in some areas ay 12
to
13.
Paano kung bumibili ng 19 kundi NFA?
Yun nga po. I'm just highlighting the segmentation of the prices po.
Opo.
So
yun po, mayroon.
What is the average, Secretary Dar? What is the average considering may mataas, may mababa, but what is the average?
Okay po, national average po ay 12 sa low, 12 pesos 37. This is fresh po, fresh. Sa high, so minimum high ganito po, ay low high, 14 pesos yung fresh. Dito rin, so average buying price sa fresh ay 13.20 po. Okay. Doon sa tuyo, doon sa dry, ang low ay 15.84 and the high ay 17.43 and the average buying price now is 16.64 po. Ganun po ang data natin.
So siguro dapat Secretary Dar na magbigay kayo ng mas maraming equipment para maging dry, para mahal.
Tama po.
May sarili silang drying facilities kasi ang mahal pala ng dry compared sa wet.
Malayo.
Tama po.
Kaya lang ang mga bodega putok din po, punong-puno, wala nang mapaglagyan ng wet.
Eh bakit ba tayo nag-i-import pa? Ang dami-dami nating bigas. 'Yun naman ang question ko sa BPI, is yung nagbibigay ng permit sa importation, but nag-i-import pa? Eh, huwag nyo sabihin because there is ano, pwede nyo naman sabihin na ayaw nyo bigyan ng ano, phytosanitary permit, di ba?
We are doing that, ma'am.
Eh, pigilin mo yung BPI mo, ay tumigil ng kapibigay ng import permit, eh, bagsak na yung presyo ng pala.
Opo ma'am, zero na itong kwan, zero itong August.
Madam Chair, importation lang po, kung ano yung kulang natin 7% lang, 93 na tatalim po. Eh yung 7%, ang import lang doon, kalahati, yung 3.5, kasi rinoroll over naman, hindi sabay-sabay naman kinakailangan. Labis-labis po ang na-import, higit-higit sa 3.5, mas lalo sa 7%.
Kaya nga, kahit nga 7%, 7% of 20 million is 1.4. Eh ba tayo nag-i-import ng 2 million? Diba? Kahit nga 1.4 lang, ang laki ng bagay nun eh. Oh, ako, I've always said that. And they're always not agree. Kayo pa mapapagalitan kami. Ano ba, senador kami, hindi naman kami nag-i-implement. But ayaw pigilin yung pag-issue ng import permit na yan. Yes, Senator Kiko.
Yes, ma'am, ang sinasabi ata beginning August, wala pang ini-issue na import permit. Tama po ba yon? Dahil...
Pero may na-issue na before.
Tama po. So, 100,000. Itong September po, zero na. Zero na ang clearance.
Pero yung mga naunang permits na na-issue, ngayon siguro pinapasok.
Pero mas kukunti na po yung dumating compared sa last year.
Oh, because hindi pa kasama dyan yung technical smuggling, yung
anti-situation,
at yung actual smuggling na...
Ang dami pong smuggled rice, ang dami, yun ang isang problema natin.
Ang dami talaga, undervaluing, rampant po.
How do you suggest, Secretary, that we address this? Is there a interagency task force between DA, BOC?
Mayroon naman po dun sa, kung tutusin, nandyan lahat po ang batas. Nandyan yung interagency collaboration. I don't know bakit may smuggling pa.
Baka hindi
kasi may pera doon. Anything na may pera, mayroong mangyayari.
Pagkano ang landed cost ng imported Vietnam or Thai rice? Landed cost?
Parang ano yan?
Almost $400 na po.
$400.
Okay. At lumalabas pagkano per kilo yon?
20
pesos. Oh, kaya mahilig mag-smuggle dahil ipapasok 20 pesos, papatungan ng 20 ano pesos.
Yes. Secretary Dar, the floor is with you.
We are strongly supporting itong joint resolution po ninyo. Pero huwag natin din kaligtaan na kung pwede na natin ma-institutionalize yung crop diversification program at dagdag din sa crop insurance.
Kunin mo na lang doon sa rice resiliency fund mo yung crop diversification. Bigay na natin lahat yung excess ng tariff sa mga farmer. That's
Opo,
the most thing. Lahat ng excess ng tariff, para wag na nilang sisihin yung rice tarification law. Ibigay natin lahat ng excess sa kanila, di ba? Whatever excess that we have, in fact, that is the power of the legislators. It's written on the law.
Tayo
mag-determine kung saan dadalhin yun. So, humanap na lang ang budget doon sa iba. But ito, we're in unison. Na,
yeah, we strongly support, Madam Chair. We strongly support, Madam Chair, the use of this for cost assistance.
Para tumigil na yung nagagalit sa atin kasi ano bang ibigay natin? Mahihirap naman sila, they need it. Now we decide on, kasi palaging rule is 1 hectare and below. Do we keep that? 1 hectare and below? Okay.
Tama po kasi... Yes, ma'am.
600,000 farmers. So, ipunin mo lahat yung excess ng rice tariff and then ipamigay mo na dun sa 1 hectare and below, which is in number 600,000 farmers. So, we approve this resolution. Yes, Senator Kiko.
Yes, ma'am. On a related matter after we approve, ma'am. I have some clarification.
Okay, so we move to approve this Senate resolution because we need this to submit to the Senator Amy.
Sorry, second the motion lang po. Akala ko natapos na.
We move to approve this resolution that we are giving all the excess, whether it's 2019, 2020, or wherever, to the cash assistance to the rice farmer owning 1 hectare and below, which is numbering 600,000, para matulungan naman natin sila in this time of pandemic and oversupply of rice in the Philippines.
Madam Chair.
That includes 2019 excess as well as ongoing 2020.
Madam Chair.
Everything.
Thank you.
Madam Chair. Yeah, the, yung sa 1 hectare and below po, we should be not fixated dun sa 600,000 kasi we have more than ma'am dun sa 1 hectare and below.
Okay lang. Yun ang sinabi nila sa amin before. Pero kung over, okay lang.
Sige po ma'am. Salamat po.
Qualified 1 hectare and below. Okay, yes.
Tama Secretary po.
Kiko. Ay, yes, Senator Kiko.
Yes, may we request the Secretary to provide us the actual figures because what we're working on here are preliminary. If they can coordinate with BOC so that we know exactly how much we will be distributing.
Madam Chair, the data that we have is about 1.1 million farmers na nasa kategorya ng 1 hectare and below.
Doble.
And tama po, hindi natin nabigyan lahat.
And may we prioritize those who were not given, number one.
Yeah,
and number
two,
may we get the actual figures so that we know exactly how much we're distributing because what we have are preliminary figures only. Can the Secretary provide this committee with the actual figures that is to be distributed given the data from the BOC and the DOF?
Yeah, okay. So, this is data from BOC.
Sorry. Paano po yung 1.4 billion na charge to 40 erring rice importers? Yung paid under protest dapat, pero hindi pa binabayad.
Anything in excess of 10 billion, we will give. Anything in excess of 10 billion, we will give as financial assistance to rice farmers. Okay? So, kung magbago-bago yung figure, bahala sila. But anything in excess of 10 billion, hindi na tayo, basta give na lang as financial assistance to the rice farmers.
Okay? Tama po.
Yes, Senator Kiko, yes.
Just to clarify an earlier point raised about the drying facilities post-harvest. I understand the 10 billion pesos that is collected, part of that should go to equipment infrastructure, hindi po ba?
They're giving. So I will tell them to include drying facilities. And besides, we have a 15 billion national rice resilience program. Mas malaki yung kanila kaysa doon sa RCEP eh.
Yes.
Nakalagay dito. Yes.
Another question, ma'am, sa DA, sa Secretary. Bumibili kasi yung NFA ng palay. Requirement sila. Hindi ba, would it not be also synergy that we provide, or there is a synergy between the Office of the Secretary and the NFA so that the NFA can also assist the farmers in milling or drying rather para mas
mag-deliver. Yeah, Madam Chair.
Yes. Yes.
We are really mobilizing NFA towards that, Senator Kiko, and actually kulang sila po ng drying facilities and milling. Nagpapamil sila sa labas eh.
Yes.
Wala sila.
And so we have directed them.
Ayaw daw nilang mag-mill sa kanilang sarili kahit meron. So,
pwede lang humirit, Senator Kiko, yung sa mga bodega. Kasi pati bodega naging racket na eh. Naging cartelized na po dito sa Central and Northern Luzon.
Yeah, that's right. Kaya kinakailangan talagang busisiin ang husto because new normal at bago na ang emphasis ng NFA. Kung magpe-purchase sila directly nga sa farmers, eh dapat meron silang capacity to be able to... yun ang dapat ng through the Secretary, total na ilipat na ulit sa DA ang agency na NFA, baguhin na rin yung paradigm ng NFA to focus on support for farmers in terms of purchasing the palay. Milling.
And warehousing and milling, yes.
Yes, yes.
Opo, we will do that.
Senator Amy, you can file a resolution to investigate. Diba? What you were saying previously that we investigate what will happen to this, what will happen to that.
Kasi yung nangyayari sa rice importation po, eh, ganun din ang nangyayari sa garlic. Ginagamit yung farmers co-op ng mga big importers at yeah, sila makuha ng lisensya. We know that racket na from before eh.
Yeah. I have filed that resolution to investigate that because they said that if you use the co-op, you are not paying tariff. Di ba? Kaya ginagamit na nung rice importer yung co-op. Nung araw, ginamit na yung co-op na yan eh. Tapos ang in-import nila less than what is indicated. They ask for import permit na maliit. Tapos, nag-import sila ng more. Nahuli ngayon kasi smuggling yon. So, since the import permit, eh, binigay sa co-op, ang nakulong yung mga co-op.
Correct.
Kaya dapat takutin yung mga co-op na yan. And in fact, the Bureau of Customs is warning na pag merong nahuli dyan, yung co-op ang makukulong. Hindi alam
naman. Madam Chair. Madam Chair.
Yes.
Madam Chair and the members, we are now finally, I mean, in the midst of studying whether to allow the co-ops to import. So ang aming orientation is to ban the co-ops to import rice.
They are being used. Yeah. They are being
ibaban
used.
Po namin. Ibaban po namin.
Hindi alam ang implication. Oo. They are being used by the traders. Oo. Ginamit na yan before eh. Nung makulong, ako pa nagbayad ng kanilang, ano tawag doon, yung para, ano, yung babayad mo para mapaalpas.
Piansa
ano
ba yun? Po. Piansa. Lahat tayo nagbayad ng piansa.
Ako pa nagbayad kasi naawa ako eh. Eh, ginamit sila eh. Nung iniimbestiga na sila, wala na yung trader. Sila na lang naiwan, sila na nakulong. Eh, kawawa yung mga co-op na yan eh. Yes.
I will, Madam Chair, I will issue the order na not to allow now co-ops and associations to import.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Actually, ginagawa...
Yes. Secretary, ay, Senator Kiko.
Thank you. Well, part of the reason na ginagawa yan ho ng mga co-ops eh dahil nga sila ay naaanggihan, ika nga.
Yes, binabayaran.
Pero ang point ko, ma'am, precisely because of the direct purchases now of LGUs mm-hmm. and national government agencies like the DSW, di pa pwede na po sa bayan and sa Gitaka, ito nga Consor Cooperative Secretary, nabanggit ko ito nung isang hearing, 13 LGUs ang bumili direkta sa kanila. Last year, 7 million ang revenue nila o sales nila. This year, 62 million. Ibig sabihin,
62 million
po. Yung isang cooperative, during the, at the height of the pandemic, year on year, from 7 million sales, naging 62 million sales dahil bumili direkta sa kanilang LGU. Doon ho natin dalin yung mga cooperatives. Para
pinapautang nga ng...
Magbenta na sila direkta sa mga LGU at yung LGU bumili direkta sa kanila.
Sige po, we will do that.
The Land Bank of the Philippines is granting loans to LGU so they can buy the rice of their constituents.
That's right.
Diba? Binigyan na nila ang Nueva Ecija, ang Isabela, I think, Cagayan.
Tarlac.
While it is restricting them from participating in importation, we bring them to this tie-up with the LGUs and other government agencies for direct purchase sa mga cooperative ito. Doon ho sila maaanggihan, ika nga, pero sa tama at diretso sa kanila.
Tayo, Senator Kiko, lahat ng pinasa natin batas na magbibigay ng processing equipment, ang beneficiary, first priority is co-op. Pag wala na lang co-op sa bayan at saka ibibigay sa LGU, it's the first priority yung co-op. Kaya talaga ma-empower natin ang mga co-op. Kaya tinatanong ko kay Secretary Dar, sino ba sa inyo mag-i-implement na pagtatayo ng co-op sa mga farmer? Kaya gusto ko yon kasi kami, palagi naming ibinibigay sa CDA yung power na yon kasi sila yung marunong doon. Okay. So I would just like to acknowledge Senator Subiri, a latecomer, and of course ang ating mga ang ating mga additional guest list, Mark Garcia of DADLSS, Senior Specialist DBM, Ms. Lori Javier, Department of Finance, the Strategy, Economics and Results Group, Director Mitch Abdon, and Officer in Charge, Assistant Director of the Agricultural Training Institute, Ms. Rosana Mula, and Department of Agriculture, Dr. Francisco Malabanan, and DBM, Ms. Queenie Tamayo, and Director Field Operations Service, Roy M. Abaya. Thank you. Welcome. Okay.
Madam Chair?
Yes, Senator Binay.
Madam Chair, more or less, who kaya kailan matatanggap ng mga rice farmers natin yung ayuda? I mean, do we have a time, may time frame ho ba? By year end ho ba matatanggap na nila ito?
Yeah, we have to legislate, di ba? So that they can, pagkapasa natin ang budget.
Pwede diba? Na magtrabaho.
Kasi this will form part of the budget na ibibigay sa kanila . Kasi under the law, it's the legislators who will approve where the money will go in excess of the ano. But the 2019, ewan ko kung, hindi ba noong 2019 nag-move tayo din? Senator Kiko, naibigay yan.
Yes, ma'am. Meron
tayong... Baka yung 2019 pwede na ipamigay.
I remember. May ginawa ang DOF together with the DA to be able to access. Naibigay yes. Na tayo, hindi ba? Secretary Willie?
Ma'am.
Pwede natin, ma'am. Pwede natin gawin ng general na anything in excess of the 6 of the 10 billion will be given as financial assistance to farmers in any year unless amended, para hindi na tayo palaging maggaganito, di ba?
Okay. Ma'am, Madam Chair.
So, yes, as DA Secretary.
Yeah, Madam Chair, kung pwede na ma-implement itong resolution as soon as possible para within December, bago naman mag-Christmas, ay maibigay na namin.
Yes. You know naman, as we want it as soon as possible, kaya i-facilitate na lang natin. Magtatanong tayo pagkatapos ng hearing how it can be facilitated. Secretary Dar, you facilitate it. Oh, because
tama, sir.
We're in unison naman na we really like it that way. In fact, yeah. I would want to pass a resolution and wala nang every time may excess ibigay na lang sa farmers na 1 hectare and below in all the years of the RCEP, di ba? Okay.
Opo.
Okay na yon. So
maraming salamat. Yes,
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Secretary, nabanggit mo yung 1.1 million of farmers. Available naman yung pangalan ng mga yan, no?
Yeah, they will right. give us. They will give us.
Mayroon farmers registry po.
Okay. We will be given the list.
Thank you. And hopefully, para maging masaya yung Pasko ng ating mga rice farmers. Mapamigay na ito.
Secretary Dai, you talk to the that we give it before Christmas naman.
Ang suggestion ko talagang dun, ilagay na doon sa resolution ninyo. Okay na yun.
Ma'am? Senator
Kiko.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Binabalangkas po natin yung rice tarrification measure, merong study yung PIDS na sinasabing the cash assistance, sabi nila anywhere between 3 to 5 years continued cash assistance as the rice market stabilizes. Kaya mabuti siguro tuloy-tuloy nga yung ganong klaseng automatic access. Thank you, ma'am.
Bring it to the floor para talagang approved by the body, di ba? Oh, sige. Okay, so we're okay now. Any more move? Okay, so we finish the hearing.
We adjourn, ma'am.
Yeah. We adjourn the hearing of this resolution and we go back to the budget of the Department of Agriculture. Okay. Thank you.
Maraming salamat po.